Hey guys, Takedown at Guardian Breach just went live today for Borderlands 3, and I'd have to say that this is probably one of the hardest missions in this game. I found this takedown a bit more difficult than the Malawan takedown because within this mission, you have to do timed events that can get you killed, and then also there's some tricky platforming where you can easily fall off the map and have to restart. Along with this new takedown, they added 6 new legendary items. They added 2 shields, 1 grenade, and 3 guns. I'm gonna briefly go over all of those weapons, show you where you can find them, and then show you guys the new OP rocket launcher that they added. This thing might be replacing Yellow Cake. They've recently nerfed Yellow Cake down to an oblivion, so maybe this new rocket launcher will help to replace it. So within this map, there are 2 major bosses. There's going to be one halfway through and then the final boss. And the one that's halfway through is really tough, but that one does drop 3 of the new legendary. That boss is Anathema the Relentless, and this one will drop 2 shields and 1 grenade, and the first shield is called Archon Asclepius, and yes, it took me several tries to say that right. It has a capacity of 14,499. Some of the other stats, it says Asclepius, and that was actually a Greek god, the god of medicine, healing, and rejuvenation. It also has a delay and a nova, and the red text reads, "Always carry a small snake," and that is referring to a quote from W.C. Fields, "Always carry a flagon of whiskey in case of snake bite," and furthermore, "Always carry a small snake." Other abilities are plus 50% resistant to elemental status effect while shield is depleted. When damaged, regenerate 3% of max health per second for a few seconds, minus 25% recharge delay, and then it triggers a 9,515 damage nova when shield breaks. It also has an anointed ability and then a 13% resistance to radiation. Now, the event just went live today, so I haven't really got to play with some of these weapons, including this one. I have messed with some of them, so I'll be highlighting the ones I have most experience with. But if this one does something crazy, I'll definitely make a video about it and let you guys know. For now, this video is just to show you guys what's out there and what you can expect to find and where to get it. The next shield that this boss drops is the Stinger. This has a capacity of 9,569, recharge delay 2.6. 6 recharge rate 3001. Other stats are Stinger, Melee, Nova, and Spike. The red text reads, "They don't let you use that no more." That's coming from a Simpson episode where they said, "We call that the Stinger, they don't let you use that no more." Other abilities are, while full, melee damage is increased by 50%, returns 5,437 damage if meleeed while shielded. This one is anointed and it has a 13% resistance to corrosive. And the third and final legendary item that you'll get from this boss is very exciting. We finally got a new legendary grenade. This one is called Lightspeed. It has a damage of 11,214, radius of 98, says longbow and lightspeed. The red text reads, "Give me a parsec," and parsec is a unit of length used to measure large distances between objects outside of the solar system. One parsec is equal to 3.3 light years or 19 trillion miles. The ability below that reads, "Longbow grenades teleport to their destination," and this also has an incendiary damage of 7,476 per second with a 50% chance. We also found one that had cryo efficiency of 167%, and these are the only 2 that we were able to get. There might be some other elemental ones that we didn't see. I messed around with this one a little bit. Whenever you throw it, it breaks off into multiple grenades and then it ricochets around. It seems like a decent grenade and it might have some tricks to it. The best I could do with it was throwing it at the ground in front of the enemy. That way it bounces up and then hits the enemy. Otherwise, it was just flying all over the place. The next 3 legendary items that you can get are from the final boss, and these are all 3 guns. One's an assault rifle, an SMG, and the new possible replacement for Yellow Cake, OP Rocket Launcher. The final boss is Scourge the Invincible Martyr, and I didn't find him too difficult to deal with. I felt like the mission all prior to this was pretty tough, but then when you got to him, it was pretty tame. Now, there are some tricks to staying alive in his arena, and I'm gonna make a full video about that. That's some stuff you probably want to know before you walk in there, because if you don't know it, you're gonna get insta-downed and probably have to restart. So one of the weapons that he drops is an AR. It's a Vladoff called Web Slinger, and I did get to play with this one and I really enjoyed this weapon. It has a damage of 1,052, accuracy 68%, handling 59%, reload time 4 seconds, fire rate 8.4, and a magazine size of 60. It also has a 1334 damage per second, 12% chance of shock, and then the red text reads, "Let's do this one last time." That's from a Spider-Man cartoon, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, and it's a line that Peter Parker says, and then they turned it into a meme. Also, right below the red text, they've added something new, and this was up updated today with this event, and it says Mayhem Level 10. So yes, the stats of this gun are Mayhem Level 10. This one is anointed, and I'll show you guys some gameplay with it. It does have a cool effect. So with this gun having the Spider-Man theme and called Web Slinger, it actually shoots spider webs. This gun handled really well. I felt like it was really powerful because it is a Mayhem Level 10, and I took it into the final boss fight and had a lot of fun with it and enjoyed the way that it performed. This is definitely one of the guns I'm going to keep on me and maybe even adjust my build around it. This was the only one I was able to get because, again, this mission and boss fight is really tough, and I don't know if there are other elemental abilities out there. The only one I was able to get was Shock. This next weapon you also get from Scourge, and I really love this one. It is a Hyperion SMG called Smog. I will definitely keep this one on me at all times. It has a damage of 5181, accuracy 71%, handling 67%, reload time 3 seconds, fire rate 6.95, magazine size of 35. The red text reads Haze Maze, and I have no idea what this means. I Google searched that and it came up with a guy playing the drums called Haze Maze at DBK 2019 Los Angeles. If you guys have any ideas about this, definitely comment down below. These stats are a Mayhem Level 10. It's got a plus 166% weapon damage, plus 10% critical hit damage, and a 2.2 times weapon zoom. The ability at the bottom is what makes this gun so great. It says damage is amplified while weapon shield is active and at max capacity. So when you're shooting from the hip, it just shoots normal bullets, and it's pretty powerful. But when you ADS, it shoots amp shots. You can see the purple streams right there. It's super powerful. I thought this weapon handled really well, and I enjoyed playing with it, and I was able to pretty much mow down enemies very easily. And yes, it is at Mayhem Level 10, so it's gonna be pretty strong, but I really did enjoy this gun. Last but not least is the rocket launcher that Scourge will drop. This one's called the Globetrotter. This is a COV, just like the Yellow Cake, and it does a damage of times 6 of 23,659, which is well above what the Yellow Cake can do now. It also has an accuracy of 66%, handling 75%, repair time of minus 5.3, fire rate of 2, and shots to break is minus 24. The red text is in Icelandic, which I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce, and it means all over the world, statues collapse for me. I cannot find what that's referencing to. I could only find that it was Icelandic, and I was able to translate it. This is a Mayhem Level 10 with a plus 40% weapon damage, plus 27% weapon fire rate, plus 396 flash damage radius. It does consume 2 ammo per shot, and it has a 1.5 times weapon zoom, and this one I have here has one of the best anointed abilities. Gain 300% increase weapon damage against enemies above 90% health. Here are some screenshots of what you could expect if you find an elemental version of this rocket launcher. The damage itself will be reduced, obviously, but it'll still be doing a times 6, but it will have like shock or radiation, but I'm not too sure about other elementals. This thing has a really cool and unique effect. Whenever you shoot it, it shoots out 6 disc-like saw blades that will project out, and I got a close-up look at these things. They look like a disc of energy and not actual saw blades, but I noticed it was making a saw blade noise whenever I was using it. So when you fire this, the discs will project out and roll on the ground, and if there's nothing in the way, they'll only go a certain distance, and then they'll start bouncing in place. If they hit an enemy, then they'll start bouncing where they hit that enemy. Right here, I'm on Mayhem 10, and I wanted to see how powerful it was, and it's doing a pretty good job, and I wanted to see if I could get out of Fight for Your Life, and I did. There was a little bit of delay because these things are like bouncing and continuously doing damage. There's still going to be more to learn about this rocket launcher and create builds around it to maximize it, and that's just going to take a little bit of time. But it seems to have a lot of potential if used correctly and around the right build and with the right character and skill tree. This might be good for a Moe's splash damage build or something like that. Let me know if you guys have ideas. I'll definitely be working on it, but I hope this helped you guys out, and we'll see you next video.